Have you ever captured a few clips using Blackmagic Camera app for iOS only to connect your iPhone to your Mac to import them and discover that you can't actually just import the clips that you need, but instead you're forced to import the entire media folder, which can be hundreds of gigabytes in file size? Well, in this video, I want to look at some best practices for iPhone filmmakers using the Blackmagic Camera app that will save you a ton of time and frustration and help import the clips you need to a Mac fast. First off, let's call out the reason why importing video from Blackmagic Camera to your Mac sucks, and this is due to Apple's woeful implementation of file sharing between iOS and macOS. Let me give you an example of what I mean. If you're on a Mac, PC, Android, iOS device, or practically anything with a file system, you can open a folder and then open subfolders until you find the file that you need. On macOS, however, a product manager somewhere deep in the bowels of Apple decided that you should only be able to access the top-level file directory for any app on your iPhone, but not any folders within it. Which is why if you connect an iPhone to a Mac, select it from the sidebar, then click on Files and reveal the Blackmagic Camera file structure, we can't actually double-click on the media folder and just import the files we need. Instead, we are forced to take the entire folder and everything it contains just because Apple apparently can't add the ability to do what Mac and iOS already support natively, opening a folder. Some video apps try to work around this limitation just by putting all your video files at the top level of the file sharing folder. For example, Cinema P3 and Kino do this, which allows you to access the specific individual files you need without importing everything you don't. A simple workaround. Blackmagic Design, on the other hand, have, for whatever reason, opted to store all the video files in the media subfolder, which means you can't open it on a Mac and pull out what you need, which is what makes the importing process so painful. But there are a few simple workarounds that we can use to overcome the issue. The file sharing limitations in macOS do not extend to the Files app on iOS. So if I launch Files on my iPhone, then tap Browse to go to the top level view, then on my iPhone, here we find all the apps that support file sharing on iOS, and this includes Blackmagic Camera. If we tap to open, we can then open our media folder and browse its contents. Let's say we just want to import this single file. I can tap, hold, and lift it, then return to the top level folder and drop it here to move it. Now on our Mac, it will appear under Files, Blackmagic Camera, and we can simply drag and drop it to copy to our Mac. If you want to copy multiple clips to the top level of Blackmagic Camera's directory, just tap, hold, and lift like before, then tap each additional clip you want to add to the selection, and then you can navigate to the top level of the directory and drop them there to move. And now they appear on your Mac, and we can quickly copy them over. And if you want to organize your media on a per-project basis, that's easy too. Under the media folder, I can tap the three dots, then choose select, then tap to add any number of clips to my selection. Next, tap the Move Folder icon, then at the Blackmagic Camera top level, tap the three dots again, choose New Folder, give it a name, tap Done, then tap Move. Again, under Files on macOS, we can grab the whole folder containing just those clips we want and copy them to our Mac. Now, you might be thinking that under Blackmagic Camera's Settings, Media, Save Clips 2, you could just tap Files and open the top level directory and you're set. All files should be saved here now, but as of v2.1, this actually doesn't work. It continues to save to your media folder. This setting only works if you connect an external SSD via USB-C and select that as your save to location. And in fact, this is another fantastic workaround and one of the best things about recording directly to an SSD. Under Settings, Media, Save Clips To, choose your connected SSD, and now there's no more importing issues on macOS. Just connect it to your Mac and use it like a regular SSD. You know, those ones that let you open folders and shit. All right, I hope these tips help speed up your importing workflow, and if it did, please give this video a like, a share, and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, I'll respond in the comments below. And remember, head over to epictutorials.com for the best LUTs for Apple Log, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.